Roaches are the worst house guests. Not only will they eat your food, but they'll poop and vomit on it too. So rude. For today's challenge, we'll show you what happens to your body when you live in a cockroach-infested house for a month. What parts of your body can they feed on? And is cockroach milk good for you? This is your body on a cockroach infestation. Cockroaches have been around since the Carboniferous era, 280 million years ago, and they're not going anywhere anytime soon. They'll probably be here long after we're gone. These insects are pests, and as carriers of a variety of bacteria and diseases, they can be dangerous too. But not everything about roaches is bad. Cockroach milk is considered a superfood. A species of cockroach called Diploptera punctata produces the milk to feed its babies. If you're lactose intolerant, you could consider drinking it. In Xichang, China, one indoor farm is breeding 6 billion cockroaches per year to harvest and sell milk. I hope none of them have hitched a ride home. Ah! It only takes a few roaches in your house to start mating. Each female cockroach can lay 10 to 40 eggs per batch. They can enter your home through any crack, the sewer system, or even your groceries. They're good at adapting to survive almost anything. They can live after being beheaded and go without water for a week. Roaches are incredibly fast and nocturnal, so you probably haven't spotted them yet. They'll likely nest in a dry area with access to food. Got a sweet tooth? Yeah, so do roaches. They love to nosh on sweets, fruits, chocolate, and pastries. They're also incredibly resourceful. They'll eat cardboard, soap, other dead or dying cockroaches, blood, and your saliva. They'll even dine on your snot. But that's not the only thing. Some species, like the American or German cockroach, feed on human skin and fingernails. So you better start sleeping with your socks on. Many gastrointestinal diseases can be passed on to humans from cockroaches carrying pathogens. Roaches that live in sewers can transport bacteria all over your home, like Shigella, which can infect a human even in low doses. After living alongside these fellas and eating the food they've touched or pooped on, you may contract dysentery. You could have severe abdominal pains and a fever. You could also suffer food poisoning from the salmonella and E. coli they've scattered around your place. After 4 weeks of feeling sick and dirty, the worst is yet to come. The cockroach droppings you inhaled or ingested can cause allergic reactions, including itchiness, dermatitis, or swollen eyelids. Prolonged exposure is linked to severe asthma in children. If you have kids in your house, you'll want to get rid of the infestation fast.
Oh my God.
Now, prevention should be your first alternative. cover cracks and openings in the drain or sewer pipes. Now, if the roaches are already in your house, act fast and eliminate all of them before the colony grows uncontrollably. Treat areas in the kitchen with insecticide. Do it frequently. A one-time treatment won't do the trick. Kill all the roaches you see and throw away the bodies so the other roaches won't feed on them. Take that, you nasty suckers. And of course, keep your home clean and don't leave food out. Now, if you think roaches are nasty, well, how about a lice infestation? That sounds like a challenge for another episode of Your Body On.